Hello, everyone, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. It's been a little bit, but bringing back to NHL Tuesdays, I'm bringing back the Minnesota Wild Be a GM mode. It's been a couple weeks since I've been able to bring it to you, but the Wild are back on the ice, taking on the St. Louis Blues, a team they're looking up at in the standings, and a good chance to get a victory and move up the ladder a little bit. In the Western Conference playoff picture, St. Louis sits, I believe, second in the Western Conference at the moment, and the Wild are on the verge of the fourth and hoping to slide up into like maybe the third place position. So as we get ready for this hockey game, good crowd in St. Louis, a resurging team who's been down on their luck for many years, but back in the thick of things now. In the first period, Zanin's big hit causes a turnover. Židlicky up ice to Heatley. This gets on Setoguchi's stick, and he buries it. Setoguchi's 14th of the season, and the Wild are on the board first. You see here, he fooled Halak stick side and gets that one to go. 1-0 Wild. You see it again there. Nice wrister. Beats Halak, and they are on the board. So in the second period, midway through roughly, this one centered back to Koivu, gets to Setoguchi, and Setoguchi scores again. His second of the game. And they're up 2-0, his 15th of the year. Let's watch this nifty passing here. Quickly to Koivu. Koivu right back to Setoguchi. And that's some nice passing by the top line to pot another goal and get a 2-0 lead on the road big time. Koivu, yeah, he's the goal scorer. He's the assist machine, but he also throws the body around, and that's why he's so valuable. He can do it all out there. And he's a great leader for this team. So you see him roughing it up, getting this game going. And here he makes a nice move offensively. Leaves the puck for Setoguchi. Can you say hat trick? Devin Setoguchi gets number 3 in the game and let the hats fly. Well, we're not at XL Energy Center, so no one's about to throw their hats here. But he's got the hat trick goal nonetheless. Nifty move by Koivu. Leaves it right for Setoguchi. Quick wrister, glove side this time. Third goal of the game, he's got all three for the Wild and a 3-0 lead. Heatley, not to be outdone, lets this blast go. And that's low glove side, also beating Halak. Not the best night for the netminder for St. Louis. Heatley is 17th of the year. He's on the board as well. How about this? This is the kind of road game you want to put on a team that is in your own conference. You don't want to take this to overtime and give away a point just for getting there. You want to dominate and win in regulation, and that's what the Wild are working on. Here's a nice play by Heatley, getting this back to Židlicky. I don't think that is touched by anyone in front, although there was a heavy screen. That just straight beats Halak. Marek Židlicky's 7th of the season, and this game ends in a shutout. The Wild shut out the Blues on the road. Nice game, nice effort by the whole team. The first line dominates, and all three of them end up in the three stars of the game. So moving on, this is a bit of an extended road trip, and the next game is going to be against the Flyers. We're taking on the Eastern Conference now after leaving St. Louis behind, and a date with Philadelphia. Never an easy place to go into and get a win, but the Wild will try to do just that. So as the Flyers hit the ice, the Wild come on out here too, and they'll be trying to get the puck by Michael Layton on this evening. We'll see what he can do in net. And Koivu, there you go. I said he was leading the team in points. There is his line right there. So face-off in the Philly zone. That shot's going to be blocked off a Zanin stick. All of a sudden, it's back the other way. Briere, oh, he just makes Backstrom look silly on the breakaway. It's 1-0 Philly after Briere's goal. His 19th of the season. Look at this. You'll see him coming on down. Defender cannot catch up. Is not about to take the tripping and the penalty shot call. And Briere buries it anyway. You see the poke check attempt by Backstrom. No go there. Briere beats that and beats him. Here's a terrible pass back to the point. Latendresse on his horse gets to this breakaway, but he cannot get the puck to his backhand to get a shot on there. Just kind of trickles away from him. Too bad. Koivu here moving to the center of the ice, putting a shot on through traffic. No go. Layton turns that away. Here we see Heatley's shot stopped as well, but a great pass to Koivu. Backhander goes. Beautiful goal here. Heatley sets up Koivu in front of the net. Koivu does not disappoint. He buries his 28th of the season. That's why he's right up there with the top leaders in the league. great goal. As you see here, look at this blind pass by Healy. Backhand quickly drags it. Koivu around Leighton just enough to get the goal. We're tied at one. Now, here's a big save by Backstrom. Taking some liberties here. Why is everybody taking shots at Backstrom after the whistle this year? This is the third or fourth occasion that's happened. Scott's going to jump in and say enough is enough on that. He's not going to win the fight because that is Jody Shelley, and he is a heavyweight. But nonetheless, sticking up for his goaltender, it's got to be done. You can't be running someone's goalie like that. Both teams a little fired up after that one, and it doesn't end there. Next faceoff, 4:45 left in the second. And once again, someone's taking a shot at Backstrom. Stoner this time is going to jump in his defense. And here we go again, round two. Stoner going to make quick work in this one here. And he's saying, you know, you really ought to stop running our goaltender because this is going to happen every single time. We're not going to let that happen. And like I said, he's going to go down right here. And as a matter of fact, he's a little messed up. Leaves towards the bench holding his face. Not real good as Stoner rearranges some things there in his face. So next face-off, another bad pass back to the point. You see Penner and Pronger chasing after this puck. Penner wins. Pronger shoves him into the net. The net comes flying off into his own goaltender. No call on here. I know Pronger is a strong dude, but that doesn't mean he should get away with doing that. Come on now. And next face-off, Pronger's still out on the ice, taking his frustration out on a big hit there. And he's going to chase this play down and unfortunately get a call for tripping. Oh boy, that box is getting full. More importantly, a power play for Philly. Here they are moving the puck around. A big shot on Backstrom, a save, and oh, we've got an injury timeout. Talbot hits the ice. He got a big hit from rookie Michael Granlund, and he's not getting up without some help going to the dressing room. Power play still continuing. This is dumped into the zones. Jelicki going to try to send it right back out, but nope. That's saved in. Nice pass to Giroux, who finds his man for the goal. Power play goal. Penner is livid. He is not happy with the turn of events here. This goal goes to Van Riemsdyk, his 15th of the year. Beautifully set up here after they held the zone. That's a great pass across the crease for the goal, beating Backstrom stick side. And this turn of events here with no call on Penner's chance and then the call against Penner left him quite frustrated. Also leaving the Wild quite frustrated here is Michael Leighton, having a very nice evening, stopping just about everything that comes his way except for the one shot that made it home. And it's a 2-1 game late into the third. One last rush for the Wild. Here you see Zanin to Granlund. Nope, that's stopped by Leighton as well. Poke checked away. A couple times here, they'll get one more chance. Penner, can he get the equalizer? Slap shot, stop Leighton, and that's your hockey game. A very well-fought game, entertaining 2-1 hockey game. Goes Philadelphia's way. The power play goal in the second period, the difference. There you see the three stars of the game, all belonging to Philadelphia. One more game to go in this episode, but here you see the Northwest Division, Minnesota. Has it by 1 point in the standings. They also have third place by 1 point over a host of teams at 51 and two more at 50. You got a logjam there, 3 through 8 in the Western Conference. So moving on, let's continue the East Coast swing. Let's get out to Toronto, which to say the least is a hockey hotbed. We are going to be in for it here. Win or lose, the Maple Leaf fans turn out to the rink to watch their hockey. They might be booing their team when they're not doing well. They let them know they expect more. They hold them to a high standard. But they're always at the rink. James Reimer, also at the rink, is going to start between the pipes. And here we go. Opening faceoff. This has gotten to Setoguchi. Setoguchi lets it blast. Oh boy, Reimer lets the very first shot go by. And the fans aren't going to like that so much. That's Setoguchi's 17th. You see, he's set up right off the opening faceoff. I believe that was Zanin that got him the puck quickly. Right inside the blue line. Lets it fly. High stick side and in the net. So Setoguchi's aim looking just fine to start this game. Here you see Latendresse trying to make some moves. Back to the point. That's broken up. And you've got a penalty call, though. There's a slash on Kim Janssen right there. Lombardi will go to the box. So in the second period, already up 1-0. What can the Wild do on this faceoff? Granlund wins it back to Kim Janssen, who's feeling all right. Jedlicki gets a shot, and that's tipped in front, deflected by Michael Granlund, and he gets his third of the season. Reimer not liking that at all, but it is a good goal. So Michael Granlund, like I said, is third on his rookie campaign as Jedlicki fired this, and somehow a very beautiful tip by Granlund, getting a piece of it. I don't even know if it, I guess it was his stick. I don't know, but it's redirected into the net. 2-0 Wild. Penner coming down ice, protecting the puck, just getting this on net. Reimer has a problem with it, and it goes through the legs. 5-hole goal. Penner's 15th of the year. You'll see the replay, and he's working one-on-one, protecting the puck, and it's one of those shots you're just hoping to get on net and produce a rebound for one of your teammates, but instead, he gets a nice bounce off the pad and in the net. So 3-0 victory on the road. The Wild take it. There are your three stars. That's going to do it for this episode. As we sim into February now, we'll pick up right in here in February in the next episode of my Wild Be a GM mode. Enjoy NHL Tuesdays. See ya.